In the winter of 2018, I volunteered at an Airbnb in Italy on my first trip to Europe. I witnessed the warm hospitality, yummy Italian food, and it was my first authentic Italian experience.
I have written about my experience in this post if you would like to check it out. In my 3 months trip to Europe, I volunteered in Slovenia in a meditation center, Estonia helping out in a wooden souvenir factory and teaching English, and in Flores Island in Portugal where I created and edited videos for my German host, and in the south of Portugal where I helped out with a writing project while staying in the middle of a national park. What do I have to say to keep you by my side? How to start in a liquefy? Need you here to tell me that it'll be okay.
Maybe one, loving two, and now it's three. 3 a.m. thinking, what if it's you and me? At the end, maybe we'll be okay. I know that you're coming back home.
It gave a whole new dimension to my travels while learning new skills. And if you know anything about me, you know that I love learning new things. Also, it's responsible tourism. It builds empathy and in a way you're giving back to the community.
It also helps in practicing new languages, provides valuable experience which might make your resume stand out as well.
I remember the first time I came across these experiences, I was blown away. There were like sailing adventures in Turkey, eco glamping in Portugal, transforming a chateau in France, and helping out in an adventure company in the Slovenian Alps. It was quite a spectrum of experiences and I was spoiled with choice. I went nuts. That's when I realized this is the kind of travel and experiences that I wanted to do, and you know, I must have spent hours there and I shortlisted like 150 plus experiences. Hi guys, I'm Raksha, and this month I've decided to make videos on the frequently asked questions of my 3 month Euro trip. If you have any questions in this regard, do let me know in the comments below and I'll be making videos in the coming weeks. Initially, I planned to do these videos after my location videos, but there has been an unprecedented delay due to hard disk issues and it has been devastating for me. Since anyway it was getting delayed, I thought I'll make these videos which might be helpful for your next travels, whenever that is. So I'm starting this series with volunteer travel because I feel it's a interesting avenue to explore which a lot of people don't know about.
Volunteer travel is not really a new concept. It's been there since the 1960s and the 70s.
But it's been mostly implemented by Westerners as a way of giving back to the community. It's a relatively novel idea in India to volunteer abroad. With the dollar to INR conversion rates, it's not really a practical thing for Indians to volunteer and travel abroad. Also, when it comes to due to the visa situation, it's not really a convenient mode of travel for us. Watch till the end for some visa tips on volunteering. When it comes to volunteer tourism, there are mostly two types. One is through companies which organizes volunteer trips, like teaching English in Africa, or rehabilitation of turtles in Costa Rica, or restoration of coral reefs in Malaysia. Or community-based projects like building a house or a park or something like that. You might have come across this. Usually these kind of programs are focused on Westerners. These usually range anywhere between $250 to $2,000-$3,000 a week. And fortunately, there are some economical ways of volunteering as well, like through Workaway and Woof. So these companies mostly connect volunteers with hosts from across the world, but they don't really organize or conduct the trips. So if you consider Workaway, it costs about $44 per person per year. In this video, I'll be talking about volunteering in Europe from a Workaway perspective because that's what I have experience in, but it's mostly applicable globally and to other volunteering organizations as well. For the uninitiated, Workaway is a work exchange program which connects volunteers with hosts from across the world. So the underlying idea is that you'll be working in exchange for food and accommodation. So since the food and accommodation is taken care of, the remainder of the expenses are mostly transport or personal expenses. So it brings down the cost by quite a lot as the days add up. So if I consider my own experience in Slovenia when I was volunteering in a meditation center, I spent less than 20 euros a week. So the food and accommodation was anyway taken care of, and we had cycle for transportation, like going around the countryside. The only thing that I bought during that time was ice creams and a sweater because autumn was kicking in. So, and my fellow volunteers, they move on from one volunteering program to another and spending about a month in each place. So you can imagine how much it brings down the cost. As you can see, each of the volunteering programs are different. So the amount you spend may depend on the location of your program and the host you're staying with and the kind of work that you're involved in.
Head to Workaway website and register yourself as a volunteer. Set up your Workaway profile, add photo as it builds more trust, and fill in the necessary details. Then choose a location that you're heading to and find relevant hosts offering work exchange programs based on your background and experience. Then apply for the volunteering opportunity, stating your details and available dates. If the host is available and interested, then they might reach out to you with the necessary details.
And from what I've seen, the acceptance rate is usually less than 5 for every 20 applications. The host may only respond after a month when it's not relevant to you, or they might already have some other person coming in. Or they may not just respond, right? So it's better to apply for as many as possible. Also, it's better to apply 2 or 3 months in advance for a better chance. Ideally, you should be able to work for 1 to 2 weeks with a particular host so that it's mutually beneficial. However, it depends on the host and the kind of work that you're doing. Some hosts look for longer term commitment, like 2 to 3 months, and some are flexible with the dates. So if you get accepted, you will get food and accommodation in exchange for volunteer work for that duration of time. Also to remember is that there are tons of opportunities for people from various backgrounds. It's not necessary that you might have to be particularly skillful at something, but if you do, it will definitely tip the scale in your favor. Also, like most European countries, they have their own native language, which means they need someone to help them with their English. So it could be as simple as teaching English, or simple things like gardening, painting, or helping around the house, helping with the kids and things like that. Although my Workaway experiences have been pretty epic, I've heard a lot of bad experiences on Workaway, like theft or assault and the likes. And yes, these incidents do happen, however few or far in between, and there is always risk involved. So proceed with caution, learn to trust your instincts, and have a backup plan. So even if things don't go your way, you know that you have an option. For me, the backup is usually a hostel. I know that if Workaway doesn't work out for me, I'll stay in a hostel and I'm not really obligated to anyone. You can also go through the reviews on Workaway and even communicate with them to understand better what you'll be doing there, so that you'll have more clarity and it makes for a better experience also. So like I said before, my first Italian host, he had an Airbnb. So apart from checking the reviews on Workaway, I also checked reviews on TripAdvisor, Booking.com and the likes. So that kind of helped me. Just going through the reviews, I got an idea that they are friendly, hospitable, and you kind of get an authentic Italian experience. And I was confident even before reaching there, because I had quite a bit of idea about it. So I think it's important to do your research before going there for your own sake. Now coming to the visa situation, it can be a little tricky. So most of the times in volunteering, they offer food and accommodation in exchange for work. But in some cases, there could be monetary benefits as well. And if there is any exchange of money for the services that you provide, then working on tourist visa becomes illegal. So you need to be really careful about that. You need to have appropriate visa for this purpose. And you need to check the volunteer visa situation in that particular country. Sometimes you can use a tourist visa for volunteering, and some cases they have a specific volunteering visa that you will have to use in case you're specifically going there for volunteering. And the rules aren't really clear in this domain, so it can be a little confusing as well. So to be on the safer side, I did not mention anything about my volunteering experience in the visa application. And to close on this topic, I would like to add that volunteer travel is not for everyone. If you are set in your ways, or if you are not comfortable staying at a stranger's house, or if you don't want to help out when you are traveling, so this isn't for you. So it's preferable when you are traveling for long term or like a gap year, because you have ample of time and you are flexible with your schedule, and also it will help bring down the cost significantly. I hope you got some idea about volunteering and Workaway as a traveler. Do let me know the questions that you have about my 3-month Euro trip in the comments below, and I'll be making videos on those in the coming weeks. If you found this video useful, then give it a big thumbs up and like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.